Hello everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. This video is the second of a four-part video series on topographic surveying with drones. Today, we are conducting a high-precision topographic survey using the DJI Phantom 4 RTK drone with ground control points for maximum accuracy. Before we start with our survey, there's some few pre-survey planning that has to be undertaken. Before flying, smart planning ensures efficiency and accuracy. This involves our survey area assessment to make sure to walk around the site and take notes of notable obstructions. And then the GCP placement strategy. Make sure to plan with 5 to 10 GCPs and a good pattern, most importantly covering the entire survey area. We go on ahead to our RTK network setup, which in our case we are going to be using the encrypt correction. And we'll move on to setting up our ground control points. GCPs boost accuracy of our survey from 5 centimeters with the RTK standalone to about 1 to 2 centimeters. We make sure to mark our GCP location, which is by spraying paint or using a pre-made target. In our case, we're using a 1x1 meter ball. For our placement strategy, make sure to use between 5 to 10 GCPs, which will be spread evenly across the site. Make sure to avoid shadows, moving objects, or reflective surfaces. Now, to measuring our GCPs with RTK GCPs, we use survey grade GNSS Rover to log exact locations, that's the XYZ, and then we record precise coordinates and our coordinates system of our choice. Now here's a quick pro tip. Make sure to take three measurements per GCP and average for best results. Make sure to ensure visibility in our images. High contrast targets such as checkerboards or the Aruco markers should be used. And make sure to avoid shadows or reflections while flying. To start our full data capture, make sure to turn on our Phantom 4 RTK drone and wait for it to initialize. We head on to turn our RTK base station for 4 centimeter level corrections. We launch our GSRTK app, which controls the whole autonomous process. Hit on the three dotted lines. Select your RTK tab and then set your RTK service tab to DRT2 mobile base station. Confirm connection and wait for some time for the DRT2 mobile station status to switch from floats to fixed. Wait further for some few minutes for the corrections to be able to take place, that is updating from the float to the fixed status. Note, the switches from red to green when the RTK base station has been fully connected or the RTK status has been updated. As surveyors, precision is of paramount to us. To be able to achieve this from centimeter to millimeter accuracy, we make sure to enter the exact positions of the D2 RTK base station. We're going to do that. We head onto our advanced settings and then we manually enter fully observed X, Y, and Z positions of the base stations. Make sure to update the latitude, longitude, and altitude position precisely from an observed GPS point. Make sure to confirm the updated position of the base station accordingly. Click on the note icons to import our boundary from the plan tab. Navigate to our boundary file. We click on the boundary file to load our boundary display on our remote controller. We tap to edit our boundary. When all settings are in place, we hit on the start button. We go through our precautionary messages to make sure our systems are in place. We look through from 1 to 5, hit on the OK button, and our boundary file is uploaded onto the Phantom 4 RTK. There's a prompt to further check before executing our tasks. We slide to execute to start our flying process. Now head over to our drone mission execution. It's time to fly our drone. The Phantom 4 RTK makes this easy with its built-in RTK corrections. The Phantom 4 RTK drone moves along the flight path created by the software to ensure total coverage of our area needed. Finally, for our post-flight validation checks, we make sure to review our images, ensuring all GCPs are visible and all the various multiple images we captured. We check our RTK logs, confirming less than 3 cm horizontal accuracy in flight logs. Make sure to back up our data on an external hard drive. We check our root mean squared errors from the points that were coordinated over our GCPs, and then finally make sure to export our data to the various industry standards as a CAD, a GeoTIFF, or CSV points lab. And that's all, guys. That is how you conduct a high accuracy topographic survey with a Phantom 4 RTK in GCPs. If this video helped, smash the like icon, subscribe for more drone surveying guides, and drop a comment if you find this method. See you in the next video. Bye bye for now.